In this video, we're going to learn about data and style properties of charts in Data Studio and see how we can use them to visualize data exactly the way we want. Hi, this is Ahmed from Sirwalk with another lesson from Google Data Studio Essentials. In the previous lesson, we learned about different types of data connectors and how we can use them to create data sources. And then we learned how to connect that data source to a blank report to create a chart. In this lesson, we learned how to customize the settings of that chart using data and style properties. Let's begin. Depending on the type of the data and the way we intend to present it, we can choose from several types of charts in Data Studio and then customize the data and style properties of the chart to visualize data the way we want. Before I start to show you the different types of charts, let's use the table that's already on the canvas and take a closer look at the data and style properties in Data Studio. First, let's move the table closer to the sidebar so we can zoom into the section. Okay, looks nice. You know from the previous lessons that we can customize the chart's data in this tab. First of all, we can choose from which data source this chart is getting its data from. This table is getting its data from the GA demo account, but we can click on the data source and select any other data source to connect to this table. Once we select the data source, then at the bottom, we can select which dimensions and metrics from that data source we want to present in that chart. This table is showing the number of new users for each page title, but let's say we want to see the number of sessions per source medium. We can easily add dimensions and metrics by clicking on one of these boxes and then selecting the field like this, source medium, okay. Or we can find the field on the right side and then drop it on the left. We can also replace the field just like that, either by clicking on it and selecting another field or by dropping another field over it. Plus, we can change the order of the fields, which affects how they appear on the chart, or we can remove them. At the left side of the field name, we can see the type of the field. And if we hover on it, it changes to a small pencil icon, which lets us change the properties of the field. Here we can rename this field. For example, we can call it source and medium, but it will only affect this same table. And if we are using the same source medium field in another chart on this report, it will be unaffected. The rest of the data properties really depends on the type of chart that we've selected, but there are a few more at the end that are common across all charts in Data Studio. Let's take a look at them. But first, I want you to note something that there is no scroll bar for this data property. So you cannot grab on something to scroll down. You have to use your mouse's wheel to scroll down on this tab. That's quite weird, but once you figure it out, you won't forget it. One of the most important data properties of any chart is its date range. This controls for which time frame do we see the data in the chart. By default, it's set to auto, which means last 28 days. But we can also set it to custom. Once we select custom, we can choose our own date range for the chart. We can either click here and choose a fixed date range by selecting the start and end date, or we can click on the drop-down menu and choose a dynamic date range. The dynamic date range will be calculated based on the actual day that the report is being viewed. So for example, if we set it on the last 7 days, every time that someone views the report, the table will show the data for the last 7 days relative to that day. Optionally, we can choose to compare the metric with another date range, for example, the previous period or the same date range last year. I'm going to set it to previous period. Let's apply. So here in the table, we can see how much each metric has changed from last 7 days to the 7 days before. Another really important property of almost any chart is a filter. With a table filter, we can limit the types of information that are presented on a chart. For example, let's say we want to limit this table to only show sessions from mobile devices. What we can do is to click Add a filter, give it a name, and then set it to include when the device category equals to mobile. The table is now only showing sessions from mobile devices. Finally, if only we're using a Google Analytics data source, we can apply a Google Analytics segment. For example, let's say we only want to take a look at the returning users. We can click Add a segment, and from the system segment, we can select returning users.
Once we do that, the segment will be applied to the chart. So now we have a table that is showing the number of sessions from returning users on a mobile device per source medium, and is comparing it from last 7 days to the 7 days before. So this is basically the data tab. The rest of the settings really depend on the type of chart that we select. Next, we'll take a closer look at the style tab, from where we can define the appearance of our chart. Once we configure the data properties of our chart, we can head over to the style tab to control the appearance of the chart and change its look and feel. While each chart type has some of its own specific style settings, there are some settings that are similar between all of them. For example, for almost every chart, we can change the fonts of different sections. We can change the font for the header and separately for the table labels. We can also adjust font sizes and colors. And in some cases, we can change the text alignment. For example, I can set the metrics to be left aligned. For a table, we can double click on the column border to adjust the width of the columns. Then, for almost every chart, we can set a background color. We can also set a border and adjust its weight, its color, and its type. For example, it can be solid, dashed, or dotted. I'm going to choose dashed. It doesn't look good. Going back to solid. We can also change the border radius. For example, let's say 25. It's too much. 20. Better. And we can also apply border shadow, but personally, I'm not a huge fan of it. Let's take a look. To be honest, it looks ugly, but it's just for demonstration purposes.
In this lesson, we learn how to customize a chart. Next, we learn about different chart types in Data Studio, their features and best practices, and how we can use different charts to tell different stories with our data. I hope you've learned something new today. You can test your knowledge by taking the quiz for this lesson, or you can continue to the next. You can find both links below in the description. If you're new to Measure School, make sure to subscribe so you get notified of the future videos that we publish. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop a comment below. Looking forward to seeing you in the next lesson.